I'm Fred from Rocky Mountain Construction, and welcome to our facility.
Hi, Fred. Thanks for having us here. We've really been looking forward to this. And even more so, we're looking forward to all these fantastic projects that have been announced that you guys got going on for next year. Can you, well, let's first of all start off with the one that we've known about and that kind of ran into a few problems, but now it looks like we've got the go-ahead for everything. So can you just tell us a little bit about wildfire and update us on what's going on there, etc.?
Okay, well, we have four projects going. Wildfire in Sweden. We have a project in California, the Joker. We also have a project in Kentucky Kingdom. We also have one in Tennessee at Dollywood. So we have a lot of work going on. We're producing a tremendous amount of track right now out of the shop here. Parts, track, cars, everything. Yeah.
So can let's just get to specific about wildfire. There was some delay as far as the paperwork with the park locally, but are you guys still looking for an opening as scheduled?
Yeah, we're still, it's still scheduled for a 2016 opening. So it did delay us. It shortened our time period that we have to build the ride. So we just have to build it faster.
If anybody can do it, I know you guys can.
We'll see. Yeah, think
even
we can.
Though, like you said, you have all these projects on your plate right now.
Obviously, we wouldn't do it if we didn't think we could.
So. Yes, and you already had the setup there at the beginning. I know, like, some of your workers were already there prior to this doing the initial work. So the groundwork was already set up before this delay had started.
Yeah, we had gotten in about 75% of the footings, and then we delayed, obviously, and so now we're back on track, pouring footings, putting wood up, so it's going. We're getting ready to start building track in the shop for it right now, and so we're moving on it.
Right, and so the track is all built here and then shipped overseas. This is the first time that something like that has been done for you?
Well, it's the first time we've shipped overseas.
Right.
So, but yeah, the track is built here in the 40-foot lengths, or approximately 40-foot. Then it is, we load it on containers and ship it overseas. And the guys over there pick it up and start putting it on. So,
okay.
Yeah.
And then, of course, everything else is just truck locally. So let's go ahead with some of the other projects. I, myself, was down at Dollywood for the big announcement. They gave us a short little construction tour. And we got to see some of the guys already working on the station, working on the lift hill, clearing out the back area behind it. How is progress going there?
It's going well. We're putting footings in the ground, doing our earthwork, footings, wood, everything at all, one behind the other. So it's going well. It's a tough site. It's very steep. We're going up and down the hillsides. It's very steep. It's tough, but we're working through it, and it's working well.
Yeah, I guess it's a little bit kind of like what you had to do with Outlaw Run.
Yeah, it's similar. It's a little bit steeper. A little bit steeper terrain, but similar.
Right, but the Outlaw Run, the whole problem, that was the biggest trouble for you guys from whenever I took the construction tour then, was the type of earth, the ground that it was on. You don't have any that kind of situation, though, in Dollywood.
No, actually, we do. We're in shale, and we're in, some cases, we're in hard rock. So, Morgan, you know, right under the surface, right under the topsoil is all shale and hard rock in some cases. So yeah, it's difficult. It's difficult, but we're hammering through it.
Yeah, well, you also had Outlaw Run to deal with before, so at least you had that under your belt, so you know what you're doing there. Okay, so now the other two projects don't require quite so much because they are existing. It's your conversions. No shell, no hard rock, and none of that. So those, I assume, are going along rather smoothly now.
They're going smoothly, but every project is unique, and even the rebuilds of these existing coasters, it's very complex. In some cases, it's easier to build new sometimes in certain areas than it is to work with existing structures and so forth. So we have to adapt and do some special things sometimes to accommodate the structures in there. So we're sometimes when, or other times when we build new, that's we can manipulate the structure and put it where we want. But so they all have their challenges.
Right. So let's get to each of these ones. What for you yourself is exciting about this year compared to the previous years that you've had?
Well, we're building four projects. They're all very exciting projects. We've got new things going in Dollywood. We've got new things going in every coaster that we're building this year. So it's all exciting. Obviously, we're launching Dollywood. The Wildfire has its own unique elements. There's all kinds of things. It's all exciting.
Right. So there you go. First launch coaster for you guys.
Yeah.
Are you doing the launch yourself, or are you having help from other company to help with that?
No. We're working with Velocity Magnetics, and they're going to provide all the equipment and installation for the launch. We're just working hand in hand with them. So it's exciting right now. The launch is. The equipment's being put together at Velocity Magnetic Shop. We're going to be testing here soon, and it's going to be very exciting. Obviously, the launch is, we're shooting up a hill, we're going over a hill. It's going to be exciting.
Right, yeah. And where are they located just for?
They're located in Pennsylvania. What's the name?
Pennsylvania, that's fine. I just wanted, so I guess you're going to be traveling then out to Pennsylvania firsthand to be able to see all this.
We've already made a couple trips. They're located out there. They have a very nice shop, a very nice facility, and they're very excited to do this as well.
Great. Okay. Without having to get into further specifics, everything seems to be going along smooth. You guys know what you're doing. We've got everything other than the launch is you now, of course. The trains for all these coasters are being built by you. Each of them, I assume, is, of course, going to have their own theme like you've been doing. Same type of train for everything? I didn't know if the one at Dollywood is going to be different because of the launch?
Obviously, because of the launch, there's a few structural differences, but the trains, they'll be heavily themed, just like we've always done, and you won't notice the difference in the trains for the launch system. Most of it's structural, and it's all underneath. You know, we have to do some different things, but as far as the look of the train and how it looks on the track and moves, and it'll all look the same.
Okay.
I mean, it'll all be the same, with the exception of theming.
Okay, let's move on to a different category. You've got now four major projects. Every year it just seems to be made more and more. You've got this new facility building you've built here now to handle the more projects because the old building just wasn't enough. The company is just growing by leaps and bounds. Like I keep talking to you every time about just how incredible it is. You're becoming the top coaster manufacturer in the world in just a few years.
Uh-huh.
But can you tell us kind of how did it all start for you? Where did you have your beginning, for example?
Well, I began in the theme park business working out here at Silverwood as a maintenance director and construction director. And then we built the coasters out there, the wood coasters for CCI. And I found out that we had a knack for repairing existing coaster track. So I started, took a small crew, we started going around the country repairing wood coaster track. I always knew there was a better way to put track on these wood coasters. So we developed this track, Alan Shilke and myself, we developed this new track, and of course, Six Flags gave us the opportunity to put it on the Texas Giant, and we took the opportunity. Once we did that Texas Giant, then we knew what we had. And we knew we had a great track, and so that's how it happened. And then obviously we got into the car business, and we're one of the few companies that actually we build all of our own product. Most everything we build. So we manufactured all right here in all these three large buildings. So we're unique, I think, in that and that. So we're design build. We do everything. We actually build out in the field. We do all the construction. We make all the product. We machine all of our own parts. We even, you know, we do a little everything. And the fiberglass we hire out for the cars, it's done by another local shop here. Very talented people. Yeah.
Yeah. So basically everything is not only made in the USA, it's made right here in Idaho.
We're made right here in Hayden, Idaho. Right here.
Yeah. You mentioned Alan Shilke. Can you tell us, how did you two end up being together?
Well, we had met in the past a couple times, worked on a couple things together, some existing wood coaster type stuff. And so that's how I met Alan, and we ever since then, we've just, you know, we've gotten along well, and that's been a great, you know, he's in my opinion, the best engineer out there in the coaster world. And so we've just created this partnership that has worked really, really well for us.
Right. And whenever you first met him, did he already have all these ideas about the iBox track, etc.?
Well,
or did that come about later on?
Well, it came about later on, and we just met up, and we both were of the opinion that there's a better way to do this than laying wood out there. And so from there it just spawned, and we just developed it and started working with it and developed it.
We've always wondered, you know, if maybe Alan always had this in his head and you were the first person maybe that came along and actually, you know, realized that he really, you know, knew it. But it sounds like it was more a collaborative thing between the two of you.
Yeah, Six Flags, like I said, they came to us, and the different track has always been mentioned, you know, here and there. And so they came to us and said, could you develop it and make it happen? And so we did.
We had
various, all kinds of ideas and various things. And then we just put our heads together and built this new track.
Right.
That's how it happened.
Right.
It's kind of just a vague, we just put it together and started working on it and said, here we go, we got it.
Okay, and then can you just, for those who aren't familiar with it, can you just say what makes the iBox track different than everything else?
Well, the iBox is it's a box beam. It's a steel box beam. Now, the topper track, we put a laminated wood beam on the backside of this rectangular running surface. So it's a steel rectangular running surface, and we laminate the treated wood to the backside of it. And so it's, in principle, they're somewhat the same type of technology, but what we do different then is we pre-build and pre-manufacture it all right here and ship it out to the site in 40-foot lengths.
Right, and then the iBox track, it of course curves in all different directions. And the question is, you know, I know you have a patent for it and everything else. You can't say maybe exactly how it's done, but that is the difference between it and traditional track. Traditional track, it's just short segments that are then individually welded together. I mean, can you just explain that a little bit, the difference there?
What often people come through our shops and they say, my God, where's that big bender that's bending that steel? And we put it all together in pieces, and we weld it all. We weld up all the joints, and that's how it's created. So it's a unique system. So all of that track that we're building comes from these large 40-foot long flat sheets of steel.
Right.
And so, yeah.
And then it's cut and then welded together and then seamless.
Yep.
And the welding is done so well that you can't even notice it. That's why they're all, the rides are so smooth,
and
which is what you can't, like you said, people can't get their head around. They expected it to be some big bender that's bending it, because there's no way that you can weld like this. But you guys...
We do, and we've bought equipment that beam welders, and we've adapted and put our own remodeling together for these beam welders that allow us to, it'll travel along the beam, and so there we weld two welds at a time, and it tracks, and so we do most of the welding with those automated traveling machines, and then we do a little bit of hand welding besides.
Okay, and then yeah. You also mentioned the topper track, which mm-hmm. is, okay, so the I-beam track is the steel track for the steel coasters that you use predominantly for your conversions, and the topper track is used for your wooden coasters that are built like the existing Outlaw Run,
right.
And of course the new one that's coming up in Dollywood.
Mm-hmm.
So can you just explain a little bit what the topper track come before?
No, the topper track came second.
Uh-huh.
And the reason that we have these two developments is the topper track is considered a wood coaster. The I-box is considered a steel coaster, right?
Right.
So regardless what the structure is, the categories dictate the category. So that's the reason. So some parks want to be able to advertise the wood coaster, and so then they go with the topper track. The technology is similar, and it takes about the same amount of time to build one as it does the other. And so there's not a lot of differences besides the laminated wood beam.
And then we've had this discussion on Coasterforce about the topper track, and a lot of people seem to think that you've done topper track for years now.
Mm-hmm.
You've done it also on repairing coasters,
mm-hmm.
such as Cyclone before it was converted. You had that all topper tracked out, I think, a few years before you did the actual conversion.
Yeah.
You've done it on other coasters as well. I think like even here locally.
Well, and that is one of the reasons why we did develop the topper track, is because we could attach it to the existing wood tracks and take out problem areas where they had, to reduce their maintenance. And it works very well for that also. But obviously we just do not have any time to do that anymore. It's all a full project or not for us right now, because we just don't have the time.
So we're not going to be seeing these old coasters restored with topper trek like we saw a few years ago, unfortunately.
We would. The reason we haven't been doing it is just lack of time,
right.
Lack of resources and time.
Mm.
So I'm not saying that we won't do it. We would, but we just have. Obviously, the company is just growing leaps and bounds,
right.
And we just don't have time to do that
anymore. Right, exactly. Yeah. Maybe we need to go even bigger.
I don't know. It's probably big enough.
Yeah, right, exactly. But then how much can you really handle, even if you have all the personnel and facilities to do everything? You've got to keep an eye on everything that you're doing. At some point, it's just got to stop.
Yeah. No, it's probably big enough.
Okay. Yeah. Well, Fred, we really, really appreciate you taking the time out again from your busy day to spend so much of it with us and answering all our questions. Of course, I can't wait to see you at the openings again, as usual.
Yep.
And hopefully you'll even have a little bit of time for us again in IAPA whenever we're down there.
I will.
Okay.
We'll be in IAPA. I'll have time.
All right. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.